expected.
Thank you.
And there it is, right where you led me. The HRAs, the prisms, they mean something to you. I need to get this prism to Marshall before it's too late. HRAs, then Dylan.
Hope wants us to compile all of Darling's data entries.
Faden, find a prism.
Corrupted organism vary so wildly. What's the connection?
Hi, Jesse.
I keep finding traces of Darling, but still can't find him. Where could he be?
But he's usually in his office in research, or one of his labs. Dr. Darling has quite a few, all around the Bureau. Could be hiding in any one of them. I check myself, but I don't have access to most of them.
Sounds like I touched a nerve.
He didn't let you into his labs?
Not all of them, no. Some had volatile material. That's ridiculous. I mean, this whole place is volatile material. Could have at least thought up a more convincing lie. I mean, how can I work without access to all the data possible?
This place has a bad habit of moving around, huh?
So you notice the building shifts. Did you know that 39% of Bureau accidents are caused by the shifts? It's true. I ran the numbers myself.
So they're dangerous.
Oh, very. Yet one time, a shark got shifted into a meeting room along with over 2,000 gallons of water. It was a tiger shark, Darling's pet research project. I forget what he was researching.
How do people work here?
You said you're an assistant?
Oh, it's just a title. I'm a scientist, a researcher. I work for Dr. Darling. See, when Bureau agents go out in the field, the sites of altered world events, we study the materials, the altered items they bring back. It's always something we've never seen before, and studying them requires new instruments, methodologies, sometimes entirely new fields of science.
Emily really loves her job.
See, there's no guidebook for what we do here. Everything that happens at the Bureau, including the science, is without precedent.
What exactly is the Ocean View Motel?
That's a bigger question than you might think. You see, I have extreme doubts that the motel is a single place. I mean, look at all the doors inside it. Where do they all go? We know that one door leads to the oldest house, but how come we can only ever open that one door? Maybe to open a door, you have to have entered through it. So if every door leads to a different dimension, plane, reality, whatever you want to call it, then I believe that the motel is firm proof that parallel universes exist.
Does Darling agree with that?
I haven't told him yet. I'm waiting until I can prove it.
What can you tell me about control points?
They're nexus points of the oldest house's unique energies. Now, I wrote a 30-page proposal hypothesizing that we could siphon energy directly from them. Darling didn't even get through the first page before he turned it down.
Right. And, has anyone ever used them to teleport around?
No. What, I mean, you mean physically? No, not that I've ever heard of. Why?
Because that's how they work for me.
What? Really? Oh my god. More tests.
Let's hold off on the tests until later, okay?
Okay, it's just, wow. This blows my control point theories right out of the water. I love it.
See you soon.
Be careful out there.
Physical alterations in his corrupted organism.
Collins, any word on survivors?
We've looked.
Had to take a detour into the quarry, but I found plenty. Here.
We will start HRA production immediately. I promised I'd tell you about Dylan once you helped us.
This is it? She knows. 17 years I've waited.
Your brother is here. He was once known as Prime Candidate 6, codename P6. We brought him here after the ordinary event. He was groomed to be the future director. He had talents far beyond any other candidate in the program.
Of course he did. We found you together. We share a bond. Are you with him now?
So you kidnapped him?
We took him in. Your parents vanished along with every other adult in Ordinary. Eventually, his power changed him. There were casualties. He wasn't fit to be the director.
Did you know about this? Is this why you didn't bring me here sooner? Were you keeping me away?
Where is Dylan?
He's kept in the containment sector, in the Panopticon.
My brother. I thought we were the same. What if we are?
I'm going. Now.
I expected as much. I need to go check on something. Something I cannot let the Hiss find. It shouldn't take long, but you must watch the Bureau while I'm gone. And remember, Dylan is dangerous. Do not let him out, Director Faden.
How do I make her stop calling me that? I'm not here for them. Nothing simple here. These people took my brother, but they've accepted me without question. Are they my enemies or my friends? I need to see Dylan. I need to know. I wish you could tell me what you know, explain things. Just stay with me, okay? I could use a friend right now. C6 is what the Bureau calls Dylan. His cell's been breached. Has the Hiss found him? Are you there with him? Can you protect him? It's been a long time since Dylan and I knew each other. I've wondered about him, what kind of man he'd grow up to be, if things as hard for him as they were for me. Maybe in here, they were even harder.
Oh, hello. Is there something I can help you with?
I'm Jesse, the new director. I need to get inside.
New director? Right. Well, okay. Hello, I'm Frederick Langston, the Panopticon supervisor. It's not the best time for a tour. We have Hiss everywhere, numerous cell breaches, and system failures across the board, but you're the director, so here we go. Founded by Zachariah Trench, the Panopticon is our state-of-the-art repository for all altered items.
I don't have time for this.
Power and...
I was told Dylan Faden was kept here. Can you help me find him?
Faden? Sure. Darling wanted him somewhere secure and isolated, away from people. He's in the maximum security cells, upper level. But there's currently a pressing matter, ma'am. We've got an object of power loose in there. It's wrecking the place. The Benikoff TV? It's a real doozy. Salvador took a team in to handle it, but no one's heard from them for hours. This is a Category 5 OOP we're talking about, and if we don't contain it soon, it will tear the Panopticon apart. And we don't want all those altered items getting loose, ma'am. No, trust me.
Dylan's in there.
Open the door, Langston. I'll handle it.
If you say so. I usually tell first-timers not to touch anything, so, just do that. Here, I'll get the door for you. And please, ma'am, call me Fred.
Thanks, Langston.
Some of the security cameras are...
The Panopticon. Dylan's close. But that object of power might wreck this place before I find him. Something went wrong with the Bureau's plan to make Dylan the next director. Marshall made it sound like it was all Dylan's fault, but how much of it was what the Bureau did to him? I don't think she's telling me everything.
Is anyone there?
What are you doing in there?
Oh, thank God. Look, someone has to watch this object at all times, or it deviates. My shift replacement never showed up. Can you help me?
Damn. I can't. I'm sorry. There's an emergency. I'll come back, I promise.
Okay, just don't forget. I can't stare at this thing much longer.
That's the object of power. I need to cleanse it.
Thank you.
Salvador, the head of security. His team didn't stand a chance against the Hiss. No one here does. Okay, the TV. Another object of power.
Thank you.
villain. He's so close.
Here. He might be nearby. Or maybe the hiss got to him. I don't know.
Jesse, listen. Dylan's here. With us. He just walked in. He says he is giving himself up. He's been affected by the hiss, but he is different than the others. We must isolate him.
I'm on my way. We need to get back. I have to see my brother.
I won't take up too much of your time today, Dylan. Like I said, I want to talk about Jesse.
Eyes open.
Hey, what can I do?
Oh, you're back. Oh, thank you. Thank you. If I look away, I don't know what this thing will do. You have to get me out of here. The door can only be opened by the Panopticon supervisor. That's Langston, if he's still around.
Langston. Yeah, I know him. I'll go ask him how to get you out.
Please hurry.